Layering your jewelry is one of the easiest ways to personalize your style. No two jewelry stacks will ever be the same, whether you're pairing earrings and necklaces or necklaces and rings and bracelets. Everyone has individual pieces in their wardrobe, and especially if you're working with vintage and antique jewelry. There's just a great way to inject personality into your outfits. So in today's video, I want to share some of the pointers I keep in mind when pairing jewelry together. These aren't rules per se, because there really are no rules when it comes to fashion, but these are pointers that might make it a little bit easier for you to navigate if you're trying to get this look, but you still come up a little bit short. You're not really quite sure why it's not working for you. Hopefully these tips will be helpful. So let's get started. So the first thing that I always consider when layering necklaces specifically is the neckline that I'm working with. So I like to fill it accordingly. So if I'm wearing a V-neck like I am today, a button-down that creates kind of that V shape, then I'll fill it with something eye-catching. I like to have something that kind of creates a statement as my main focal point. And then I work from there, and I fill smaller pieces on up the chain so that nothing feels too busy, but it feels very purposeful. In my experience, an empty space almost does more talking than something that's been filled strategically. So by using jewelry, you help fill the area, but not make it overpowering, if that makes sense. Now, when I'm working with a crew neck, I like to leave a little space above and below, especially if I've got a thicker collar around the crew neck. So sometimes you'll have fabric that's been folded over. It creates almost like a hem effect. If you know the name of that, please let me know in the comments. And I don't like anything too close to that. It starts to feel a little claustrophobic for me. So instead, I'll either go above or below. And I like to go below by a couple inches typically. I like to have some space, and again, the whole purpose is to just kind of draw the eye where you want it to go. So if you keep all of the focus too close to your neck and your jaw, in my experience, it makes it feel really crowded. And I know for me, it makes my neck feel shorter. And that's not really the look that I'm going for with this layered look. So instead, I like to make things look long and lean. And doing a longer necklace really helps do that, especially when working with a crew neck. The next thing I like to consider is the weight of the jewelry that I'm wearing, so the thickness basically. And I like to pair like with like, so thick jewelry with thick jewelry and lighter, delicate jewelry with light, delicate jewelry as a general rule. Now, of course, this is definitely something that I tweak as I go along, but I find that it reads very purposeful that way. It looks like those pieces maybe were purchased together as a set, and I like that look. It's a really nice way to make it look intentional. And of course, make it look like your outfit was very custom to you, which you know that I love. So I also like to consider how far away the pieces are from each other when working with the different thickness. So if I'm working with thick earrings and I also want to wear a thick necklace, I will make sure that they have a good distance between them. Maybe instead of wearing long, thick earrings, I'll wear small, thick earrings, and then wear a thicker chain that's hanging maybe slightly longer than I typically wear. And that way it looks like it goes together, but it's not too much. It's not, whoa, that's a lot of jewelry. And instead it's, ooh, I like how that all kind of goes together. It's a very thoughtful way of doing it. Next, I think it's important to try to keep things as balanced as possible. It's a really easy tool to keep in mind so that nothing feels too over the top. Instead of feeling a little bit like Mr. T, you feel like a really chic woman who just happened to throw on a lot of jewelry and it just looks so effortless and perfect together. And I think a good way to go about that is to make sure that if I'm wearing something thicker, I go slightly thinner in the other departments. So for example, if I'm wearing thick earrings, I will maybe avoid wearing really long thick earrings and a necklace. And if I want to wear a necklace, I'll pair maybe smaller thick chunky earrings with a more delicate necklace that also is a little bit further away. I don't like to pair things that are too chunky and bulky really close next to each other, and instead like to give the eye a place to travel to. Kind of like reading a story. So the beginning would be the earrings, the middle would be the necklace, and then the end would be the rings. And everything should look like it's part of the same story. And so by keeping things similarly weighted, but not letting anything overpower another, it looks very good. It's just, it reads very nice to the eye. It's something that we're kind of trained in nature to see. So when you do it in your outfits and your jewelry, it feels very pleasing. I also think it's really important to consider your canvas when layering and wearing jewelry. So if I'm wearing a printed top, I'm less likely to layer a lot of necklaces over it. And instead, I like to fill the empty space. So I like this one shirt, for example. It's got a nice V kind of look to it, but it is kind of a busy print. So instead of adding necklaces over top of that, I add them in the empty space. It helps everything just look really good. And again, not let any one thing kind of compete too much. You don't want anything to scream too loudly if you want to go for a more subtle layered look. So I will also consider the color of my jewelry. So if I am wearing a cool toned print, I'll be less likely to layer a lot of gold on top of that. And the reason is because that clashes to your eye. Naturally, you want to pair cool with cool and warm with warm. So I will maybe skip the necklaces and instead wear gold rings or gold earrings and make sure that I have that distance between the pattern and my jewelry. So when it comes to layering necklaces, it's really just a matter of trial and error and just wearing things together until you hit that sweet spot and you're like, oh, I like how that looks. Then you call it. That's the time you walk away from the jewelry box and that is your layered look for the day. But if you are someone that likes a more mathematical approach, maybe you want some rules that you can follow, then typically it's a good rule of thumb to make sure that your necklaces are at least an inch, maybe 2 inches apart from each other. And then also you want to work from small to large. So start with the thinnest up top and the smallest pendant up top, and then work your way down to your thickest pendant and your longest pendant, and then the biggest charm or whatever it is that you have on that necklace. That's a very nice way to layer things. It looks really good to the eye. It's a very cohesive story, and it's something that your eye naturally follows. So it could be a really good way to start playing around with them until you start to train yourself. So instead of getting frustrated, you can just go small to big, short to long, and you should really have a look that's perfect no matter what you're wearing. So for me personally, one of the most underrated parts of layering and pairing jewelry together is to make sure that the textures match. I know it's something that you can easily overlook, but it makes a really big difference in how I feel about my layered looks. So instead of pairing something with a rough texture with something really smooth, I will pair smooth and a little bit sparkly with smooth and sparkly. It just looks better that way in my experience. It again reads very intentional and it looks like those pieces are supposed to be together. They're all siblings or cousins and they all kind of look like they're part of the same family. Instead of maybe having something that's got a really nice, jagged, almost antique texture and something that looks really polished and new, that can be a little too much juxtaposition for me and my personal tastes. But if that's the look that you're going for, then that is a great way to instantly add interest. That contrast will immediately attract the eye and really say something about your look. So just like I like to pair similar weights with similar weights, so thick jewelry with thick jewelry, and make sure that everything kind of stays balanced, I also like to make sure that not one side of my body looks too jewelry heavy. I don't want it to look like I'm off balance and maybe the left side should be heavier than the right side. So I like to wear a similar number of jewelry on each hand, and I always make sure that everything looks even. So for example, if I'm typically wearing my wedding and engagement ring on my left hand, I'm not at the moment, they're being serviced, so I'm wearing a smaller stack, but if I wear that on my left hand, then I'll wear a ring on my right hand. It's typically my signet ring. And then if I wear my signet ring and maybe a small stacked ring, I like to separate them. I don't like to wear them too close together. I find that having my signet on my pinky and then my small stacking ring on my pointer finger is enough distance between the two so it looks even. And then if I'm wearing a bracelet on my right hand, I'll typically wear a watch on my left hand. And I like to just, again, make sure that it looks like it's even so the scale doesn't tip too far to one side. And it's really helpful because it's very easy to kind of get off balance with your jewelry. And it's a look that can make you feel like something's just off when you're looking in the mirror. So when in doubt, take it off and start over and do the one-for-one rule. So if you put something on your left hand, add something to your right hand. Or wear nothing. That's another great way to keep it balanced, and maybe just wear earrings and just a necklace. And then also, if I'm wearing earrings and a necklace, I'll go a little bit lighter everywhere else. I personally don't like to look like I'm wearing all of my jewelry at the same time. So instead, I like to make it look intentional and purposeful, like I've been saying throughout this whole video, and making sure that not one side speaks a little too loudly or louder than the other is a really good way to do that. And there you have it. Those are some of my tips for layering your jewelry and pairing pieces together. I hope you found this helpful and maybe it inspired you to try this look out for yourself. And I would love to know in the comments down below what your favorite jewelry piece is. I have a few in my wardrobe. I don't know if I could pick just one, but I would love to have you contribute in the comments down below so we can talk about our favorite jewelry. Jewelry's so fun. And like always, thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you in my next one. Have a great day.